joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and heaven and nature sing. Joy to the world, the Savior reigns. Your sweetest songs employ. While fields and floods, rocks, hills and plains, repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy, repeat, repeat the sounding joy. He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of his righteousness, wonders of his love, and the wonders of his love, than wonders, wonders of his love, and wonders, wonders of.
Welcome. We approach Christmas Day, and I hope your preparations are done. Well, if not, it's too late, so simply relax. Our short watch night service will have some readings and some carols and some songs, and if you hear the noise of snoring in the background, I've been joined this evening by the dogs, who have taken their usual position at my feet and are sleeping soundly, if a little noisily. So I hope it is not too much of a distraction. This short service is really about giving you time to reflect, time to take stock, time for a deeper awareness that God is with you. The carols that we have will have the words appear on the screen, so if you want to join in, feel free. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of the shadow of death, a light has dawned. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness. From that time on and forever, the zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this.
O little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. For Christ is born of Mary and gathered all above. While mortals sleep, the angels keep their watch of wandering love. O morning stars together, proclaim the holy birth, and praises sing to God the King, and peace to men on earth. How silently the wondrous gift is given. So God imparts to human hearts the blessings of his heaven. No ear may hear his coming, but in this world of sin, where meek souls will receive him still, the dear Christ enters in. O holy child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in, be born in us today. We hear the Christmas angels, the great glad tidings tell. O come to us, abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel.
I would invite you to join with me in a prayer if you wish. If not, that's fine, but simply a short prayer. Father, the wrapping is done, the tree is dressed, night descends, and we pause to listen for the deep voice of God speaking through these things, the deep purpose, the deep promise of Christmas. When we have been too busy, too loud, too distracted, God knows and forgives us. So now we listen. Speak peace and hope into our hearts, we pray. Wrap us in your love, dress us in grace, and hold us close to your heart, that we may know a little more of your greatness and glory, distilled into a child for our benefit, for your kingdom's purpose. So speak to us the words, speak to us through the songs, and relight in us the flame of faith, for we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. In the sixth month, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings to you who are highly favoured. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, for you have found favour with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you will give him the name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked, "since I am a virgin." And the angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. so the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age. And she who was said to be barren is in her sixth month, for nothing is impossible with God. I am the Lord's servant, Mary answered. May it be to me as you have said. And then the angel left her.
While shepherds watch their flocks by night, all seated on the ground, the angel of the Lord came down, and glory shone around. Fear not, said he, for mighty dread had seized their troubled minds. Glad tidings of great joy I bring to you and all mankind. To you in David's town this day is born of David's line, a Savior who is Christ the Lord, and this shall be the sign. The heavenly babe you there shall find, to human view displayed, all meanly wrapped in swaddling bands and in a manger laid. Thus spake the seraph, and forthwith appeared a shining throng of angels praising God, who thus address their joyful song. All glory be to God on high, and to the earth be peace. Good will henceforth from heaven to men begin and never cease.
Have a short video clip. It's a little sketch, let's call it that. But I wonder if it reflects so many of our Christmas experiences.
Hark is the bell.
Bill and Estelle from number 7, they bought a present. This for me, who is this from? Just pass it on.
Ashtrays for smoke,
we do not smoke.
Home, don't be smart.
Perhaps you could start.
Merry, 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 merry Christmas.
Merry, 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 merry Christmas.
Santa for a day must spend on just £5 or less.
Perhaps I forgot, not have I ruled. What have we here?
it's overdue. Merry, 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 merry Christmas.
Merry, 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 merry Christmas.
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, magi or wise men from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born the King of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Christ was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem in the land of Judah, are by no means the least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will be the shepherd of my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and make careful search for the child, and as soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way. And the star that they had seen in the east went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary. They bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gold and the incense called frankincense. And more.
Shepherd.
You've made it through to almost Christmas. This one has been more unusual than previous years. For some, it's been easier cutting out the extra things that really aren't necessary. For others, though, it has been harder, more stressful, trying to work out how to be with family and friends this year. Perhaps you have come to the conclusion that you simply can't do everything. And you have to do something more stripped down, more simplified. And that's okay. You have to accept that. Simplification is good. It allows big things to be contained in small packages. We say a picture paints a thousand words. So a simple idea, a simple image, can contain a big message. God did the same at Christmas. He took his bigness and made it small for us, to help us understand it, to get it, to relate to God who wants to relate to us.
This earth is home, while men seek fame and great renown. In lowliness, our King comes down. Jesus, Jesus, precious one, how we thank you that you've come. Jesus, Jesus, precious one. You left the sound of angels' praise to come to man with unkind ways, and by this baby's helplessness, the power of nations is laid to rest. Jesus, Jesus, precious. What kind of king so small, from glory to a humble stall. That dirty manger is my heart too. I'll make it a royal throne for you. Jesus, Jesus, precious one, how we thank you that you've come. Jesus, Jesus, precious one, a manger throne for God's own Son. In it, dear Lord Jesus, I ask by me forever and love me, I pray. Bless all the dear children in thy tender care and fit us for heaven to live with thee there.
The challenge for many of us at this time of year is to make space. Make space for the deep story of Christmas. It gets crowded out by tinsel and flashing lights, all that rushing and pressure. Reminds me of the events in Bethlehem. Senseless, that big event, the place mobbed, overwhelmed with activity of rush and bustle. And into it God tries to say a new thing, a new action. And think of the response he got.
Family hiding from the storm, found no place at the keeper's door. It was for this a child was born, to save a world so cold and hollow. The sleeping town, it did not know that lying in a manger low, a Savior King who had no home had come to heal all our sorrows. Is there room in your heart? Is there room in your heart? Is there story? Shepherds counting sheep in the night, do not fear the glory light. You are precious in his sight. God has come to raise the lowly. Is there room in your heart? Is there room in your heart? Is there room in your heart for God to write his story? You can come as you are, but it may set you apart when you make room in your heart and trade your dreams for his glory. Mother holds the promise tight. Every wrong will be made right. Road is straight and the burden's light. For in his hands he holds tomorrow. Is there room in your heart? Is there room in your heart? Is there room in your heart for God to write his story? You can come as you are, but it may set you apart when you make room in your heart and trade your dreams for his glory. Make room in your heart. Make room in your heart. Make room in your heart. Make room in your heart.
The deep truth of Christmas is that it is not something tied to a single event or season of the year. It is something that people of faith carry in their hearts each and every day. It is a hope. It is a message of healing, reunited, reconciling with God. He knows each of us completely. He knows our hearts, our fears. And he wants to be a part of our lives, to bring his healing, to bring his restoration. And all we need to do is let him in.
I hear your hollow laughter, your sighs of secret pain, pretending and inventing just to hide your shame. Plastic smiles and faces blinking back the tears, empty friends and places all magnify your fears. If you're tired and weary, weak and heavy laden, I can understand how it feels to be alone. I will take your burden if you let me love you. I'll wrap my arms around you, give your heart a home. It hurts to watch you struggle and try so hard to win, but trade your precious birthright for candy-coated sin. Wasting priceless moments, restless and confused, building up defenses for fear that you'll be tired and weary, weak and heavy laden. I can understand how it feels to be alone. I will take your burden if you let me love you. I'll wrap my arms around you, give your heart a home. Take my yoke upon you and walk here by my side. Let me heal your heartaches and dry the tears you've cried. Never will I leave you, I'll never turn away. I'll keep you through the darkness and lead you through the day. If you're tired and weary, weak and heavy laden, I can understand how it feels to be alone. I will take your burden if you let me love you. I'll wrap my arms around you and give your heart a home. I'll wrap my arms around you and give your heart a
instead of hearing, "For God so loved the world," try putting your name in. For God loved so much, and still does. You can know that love in your heart, in your life, even now, whether it's for the first time, or if your faith has grown a little cold and dusty, something of the past. Now is the time that God is happy to fill you up or refill you. And it's simply a prayer away. Just ask Him back into your heart, back into your life. He will never force Himself in. He's not like an unwelcome guest. We need to invite Him. So just ask Him to come in. Come into your life. To forgive your past. And give you a new future, and to walk with you each and every day, and He will.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till He appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, O hear the angel voices, O night. Christ was born. Oh, night divine. Oh, night. serenely beaming, with glowing hearts by his cradle we stand. So led by light of a star sweetly gleaming, here came the wise men from Orient land. The King of Kings lay thus in lowly manger, in all our trials, born to be our friend. Fall on your knees, O hear the angel voices, O night divine, O night when Christ was born, O night divine, O night, O night divine. Truly he taught us to love one another. His law is love, and his gospel is peace. Chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we, let all within us praise his holy name. Christ is the Lord, man ever, ever praise we, his power. Evermore proclaim his power and glory. Evermore proclaim. So fall on your knees, O hear. Christ was born, O night divine, O night, O night divine.
Can we pray briefly again? God of grace, mercy and peace, fill our Christmas afresh with your presence. May we know your love, and as we gather with family or friends, in person or virtually, as we try to tell of our love for others, may we hear your telling of your love for us in Christ. May we rediscover the wonder and worship of Christmas. Bless us and our families and loved ones. We remember those who are ill or struggling today. We remember lands in conflict and in strife. And pray that somehow, even beyond our understanding, you will be there, making the difference, changing the outcomes, reconciling all of your creation back to yourself through Jesus, in whose name we pray.
O come, all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. O come ye, O come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. True God of truth, light of light eternal, he who abhors not the virgin's womb. Son of the Father, begotten, not created, O come, let us adore him. O come, let sing like the angels, sing in exaltation, sing with the citizens of heaven above. Glory to God, glory in the highest. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Yes, Lord, we greet you. Born this happy morning, Jesus, to you be glory give. Word of the Father, now in flesh appearing, O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him.
This Christmas, may your life and homes be filled with laughter and love. May the blessing of God be with you, through Christ and in Christ. I thank you for taking the time to share in this service with me. And I can only pray that you have a wonderful, wonder-filled Christmas this year.